The Legend of Zelda series' incredible gameplay, set against the backdrop of the mysterious Kingdom of Hyrule, combined with the intentionally vague and sometimes infuriating hints scattered throughout the games, has led to a robust rumor mill. With Zelda fever at an all-time high these days, there's no better time to debunk some of the more persistent, totally untrue facts about Link's many adventures. The Error. In The Legend of Zelda 2, Link meets a man named Error. That's an odd name, even in Hyrule. So players have wondered for years if it was a mistranslation or some sort of glitch in the game's code. His name is Error, after all. That's not the kind of name you would give someone who's supposed to be here. But the truth is that the name is completely intentional. It's actually the mistranslation of another character's name that muddied the waters. Later in the game, you encounter a character incorrectly named Bagu, which is how bug is phonetically written in Japanese, as in computer bug. So there was supposed to be a character named Bug and another called Error, and that was Nintendo's idea of a joke, yeah.
Well, excuse me, princess.
Running rumor. The Legend of Zelda: Ocarina of Time is one of the best Nintendo 64 games that doesn't star Mario or James Bond, and since it was released during the AOL Netscape days of 1998, was the first to have many elaborate internet conspiracies published about it. One involved a character known as Running Man, who challenges you to a race. The problem is, he always beats you exactly by 1 second, no matter what. Or does he? In 2009, YouTube user Rusty Sporks uploaded a video claiming he had beaten the Running Man by making Link jump 7 years back in time, then simply wait at the finish line for 7 in-game years. That's an entire week in real life. But Zelda fans on YouTube quickly pounced on Rusty Sporks, proving that the Running Man is, in fact, programmed to win every time, and his video was all a hoax. One fantastically nerdy user even proved Rusty's fake dialogue isn't in the game code. Triforce Tease. Ocarina of Time is one of the few Zelda games where you don't get access to the Triforce, the magical MacGuffin that appears throughout the series. Even still, gamers claim for years that they found it, using photoshopped screenshots or footage of an early demo featuring the magic relic, but it's just not possible. Someone along the way probably insisted their uncle that worked at Nintendo told them how to find it.
And once you stop, it'll sprint bounce up again, then you can go underneath that one. Yep.
Coolest uncle ever. Perhaps the most famous fake method to obtain the totally fake Triforce was spread by a player going by the name of Ariana in 1999, who claimed it required players to perform a special song on the ocarina called the Overture of Sages. Zelda fans pointed out that Ariana's less-than-stellar Photoshop skills gave away the hoax, and she confessed it was all just for laughs. Hey, you had to get your pre-MySpace internet fame however you could. Just ask whoever made the hamster dance. Door to Nowhere. The Legend of Zelda, being a series that encourages exploration, can make lots of players believe that any building is available for entrance, whether the owner wants you there or not. So it feels strange when there is a door that you just can't enter, even with a well-placed bomb. Oops. Fado's always locked front door in Twilight Princess is a perfect example. The only thing gamers hate more than waiting for an update to download is a door that never opens. This led to all sorts of rumors and fake tips to get inside, until gamers managed to glitch their way into his home a few different ways. Well, it's not really a home.
It's just a pointless blank space, or a meaningless, unfathomable darkness from which Link can never escape.
Sort of like adulthood. Fun.
According to Zelda mastermind Eiji Aonuma, there simply wasn't enough time to create the interior space, which is why poor Fado is forced to live in a horrific empty void.
Beta Forest is a bust. Early trailers for Twilight Princess included many characters, enemies, and areas that never made it into the final game, including a forest area featuring a bunch of cute cats and an ancient statue. Unfortunately, this so-called Beta Forest was abandoned by Nintendo during the testing phase, not unlike how one abandons their rad, vaping smoke ring blog when they get approved for grad school. Even though the Beta Forest went up in smoke, gamers are still trying to find it. It's like the lost city of Atlantis. But all their hacking and glitching just leads to an ultimately pointless, shuttered part of the game. Sorry, internet. Hope you can now see the forest for the trees and spend your time a little bit beta. Thanks for watching. Click the grunge icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love too.